Wait, the new phone book came today. Who likes to do the Steve Martin thing when the phone book comes in?
I usually throw my own trash.
I just grab it, and I run through the house like a mental case, and I go, the new phone book's here, the new phone book's here. Yay!
No.
Yay! Remember that from Steve Martin, the jerk?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, that could be a millennial thing when the phone book comes. You just throw it away.
The phone book's here. Yay! Anyway, this guy says...
Back in the day in the outhouse, it was either the phone book or the Sears catalog, you know? And that's what
Well, the Sears catalog was a lot more interesting because you can go to the underwear section and masturbate to it.
So sad.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Because that's all you had. It was either that or it was the copy of National Geographic when they went through Africa.
Oh, my God.
That's all there was. Right? That's all you can get your hands on. I mean, today, I just found out today that who gave up the – it was the Miss America pageant, which I think is on tonight. Right? And they said they're giving up the bikini round. Mm-hmm. And, of course, people are wondering, like, oh, a controversy. They're giving up the bikini round. They had that for years. And I'm thinking, you know why they gave up the bikini round? Because the whole show is so fucking boring.
Yeah.
We're not going to watch it for TNA. We have the internet now.
Yes, right.
You know, we're not going to sit through 3 hours of boring as hell evening gown rounds just to have a few minutes of TNA because it's not the 1970s anymore. Okay, we would do that 40 years ago to have a glimpse of TNA. We don't have to do that anymore. So, of course, they got rid of it.
If I was to win the crown, I would hope for world peace.
Oh, God.
Oh, and by TNA, Catboy doesn't mean the wrestling. He means tits and ass.
Oh, yeah, right. Just wanted to make that sure. Everybody knew that. Yeah. But sometimes TNA, the wrestling, does stand for tits and ass. You get both.
Mm.
You know, because they have the girl
wrestling. That's true.
And they're always cute. They're always cute. All right. You remind me of the old days when the Road Warriors were around. Remember those guys? They were my favorites. When I was growing up, I wanted to be like the Road Warriors when I was a kid. I actually attempted wrestling. I went to a place called Hull, Quebec, with a friend of mine, a guy named Derek Cameron. And we were really into like weightlifting back in those days. We were the only people on the bill that were actually big enough to qualify to wrestle for the WWF because they had a rule. You had to be over 6 feet tall and over 202 pounds. And we were the only guys there that were that big.
Hmm.
And we had to lose to a couple of French Canadians that were like 175 pounds each, soaking wet.
Hmm.
You know? Yeah, which was really humiliating, I might add. And we went through all this trouble to invent some characters. What we did was we went to Goodwill. We picked up some old football equipment. We spray painted it black and we put spikes all over it that try to look like the Road Warriors. We show up in this makeup, and then the guy who was the promoter, and he said, you don't have to bother with that. Harry, I got your villain thing right here.
Mm.
And back in those days, this was the late 80s, everything used to be bilingual. When you had a sign, it had stop and arrête on it because apparently French people are too stupid to know what the hell stop means, even though it's everywhere, right?
Good
but what thing. He did was we took we took a red can of spray paint and we sprayed out the French part that says arrête, so it only says stop, and that's what makes you a villain because we were wrestling in Quebec.
No.
Right? Oh, we're the English guys. Oh, you see, that's what makes you the villain. Yeah, you don't have to worry about the makeup and the spikes and looking like punks or anything. Just hold up the sign, you know, that says, you know, they can see that part was spray painted out, and everyone will just boo the shit out of you. And sign was really stupid, but it was a really good outside weapon. It was great for hitting people over the head with. Because it makes a lovely sound when you ring someone over the head with it, like, bam, you know. That was a lot of fun. But, unfortunately, I found out that every time somebody body slammed me, I would be so dizzy I couldn't stand for a whole minute.
Mm.
My inner ear just won't work. Yeah, so I had to give that up. That was not my career.